morning, y'all. Today is Wednesday, March 29th, 2017. Beautiful, beautiful morning. Well, minus the sunshine and the warm temperatures. But I guess it's a beautiful morning to be alive. It is cloudy today. It's actually not that cold. It's a little bit chilly. But I'm not even wearing a jacket, so I can't complain. It's not that cold. But we are, once again, heading over to my father's house. We are going to hang out for a bit today. Not sure what we're going to do, what we're going to get into. But as always, you guys are coming along for the ride. And hopefully we will do something that you guys enjoy watching. So let's go. Dad, where are we going?
Going crazy.
And then where are we going?
Really crazy. I noticed the trees are starting to leaf out and blossom. And we're getting a lot of color. That's interesting. I saw those trees that have the white petals are turning really white, and the ones that have the red or purple are turning really purple. Pretty cool.
Well, we need to go do some photography here soon.
I'm ready. Be interesting.
The tree that my dad and I cut down is all of a sudden alive. It's all full of all these purple blooms and all these cool looking little flower things, but the tree's down on the ground. So, I mean, it bloomed last year too, but the tree trunk itself was split in half. The tree was done. It was unsafe. We had a real big storm come through. I didn't want any of the branches to fall down on the dogs or anything like that. So we cut it down anyways. But Esme and I went outside yesterday and just thought it was funny that the tree that we decided to cut down is all of a sudden blooming these pretty purple little flower things. But we will hopefully be doing a photography video for you guys soon. Around here, around this time of year, there's a tree. Now, it's a nuisance. They don't like it. They say that it is, I don't know the exact word I'm looking for. It overgrows, overtakes a lot of other native trees. This is not a native tree. But I don't know the correct terminology, so pardon me for having a hillbilly moment. But they're gorgeous white trees, and they usually start turning white before anything else even starts to turn green or start to bloom or anything. And a lot of them are, actually, see if you can see this one here. I don't know if you can see. Probably not. Maybe I can slow it down and you can see. But around here, we just got these gorgeous trees, so I want to be able to go and do some photography and get some of those trees captured. I was not able to really do it last year, and I'm wanting to get it done this year. So we'll be right back.
with this taco. How's your food, Dad?
Muy bueno. Bueno. Frijoles and rice. That's good.
Well, in case you guys could not tell, my dad and I went to Mexican food for lunch. It was delicious. I had some tilapia, beans and rice, and I ended up just making some fish tacos. My dad got some beans, rice, pico, guacamole, and made himself up a little dish, and it was a really good food. So we're about to head out and see what else we can get ourselves into. Coming into our local hardware store to get some oil for the chainsaw. And I guess we're gonna go back to the house and finish chopping up some of the wood that we started on the other day. So let's get that done. Got out of the I guess it's True Value Home Center, little hard home repair store, whatever you want to call it, hardware store. We got some oil for the chainsaw. Now we're heading home, or to my house home, and I guess we're gonna, like I said, chop down some more of the tree that we started on. And yeah.
That's all the wood chopping that we're doing today. For those of you who don't know, my dad has a Greenworks chainsaw. It's a battery operated one. I did a video on my Greenworks lawnmower. We have a push lawnmower that's Greenworks. It's all run on these 40 volt lithium batteries. They make a pretty big variety of battery operated equipment, chainsaw, weed whackers. I have a weed whacker as well, blowers, all that type of stuff. Anyways, the batteries that I have were not fully charged, so we ran out of batteries today, but we did do all of this with that Greenworks chainsaw, so pretty cool.
Got too close.
Just got back to my dad's house. We are pulling in this driveway right now. Not sure what else has in store for us today, but it's gonna take me a little while to edit this video because this is already clip number 31. So I hope you guys appreciate all that we go through to make these videos for you guys. Not complaining because I enjoy doing it, but I'm just saying, I gotta turn all these clips into like a 10 minute video for you guys. Anyways, so far it's been a beautiful day. Ain't got nothing much to complain about. Dad's right there checking his mail. And like I said, just hanging out. Tired. Just left my dad's house, headed home. But first, I gotta stop by, return a movie. I might run in the store and grab something to drink. I don't know. But we are on our way home. Go hang out with Esme. Probably just sit there and watch TV or something. I don't know. Alright you guys, there's going to be a little treat for you guys tonight. I'm going to show you how to make something that I really, really enjoy eating. It is something that's fairly easy to make. It's a little tedious, but the end results are delicious. I don't have a name for them. I just call them stuffed rolls or stuffed buns or stuffed bread or however you want to say it. But I've done it a couple different ways. I've done it stuffed with a couple different things. Tonight it's going to be stuffed with a mixture of ground beef and pork, some purple cabbage, and some special rice that I've made. Anyways, I'll show you guys how we do it. And if you guys want to try it, I recommend it. It's absolutely delicious. And here we go. All right, guys. So what I do is I take these biscuits. Doesn't matter really which ones you use. I like to use the jumbos. Today I'm gonna try the flaky buttermilk. And you just open them up. Sometimes I have a hard time doing it.
I will.
Nope. Pops open. Set these aside. And you take one, kind of flatten it out, make sure your hands are clean. My hands are clean, I just washed them. And you roll them out. That should be about okay. Make sure that you can pick it up without too much of an issue.
All right, so have a nice little flat area. I am going to put cheese on mine. You guys don't have to put cheese in yours, but I want to put a couple pieces of cheese like that. And then I'm gonna take a scoop of my mixture. I'm gonna stick it right on there. Now this can get messy and that's all right. Whatever is left over, you can either throw away or go ahead and pick it up and eat it, which is a smart thing to do. And you just kind of fold them over. Let the dough start getting onto each other. Like that, you know, start folding the dough on top of each other.
This one.
And the cool thing about it is you can stretch the dough, all that type of stuff. Now, it doesn't have to look pretty, but you want to make sure that everything is closed up. All the dough is wrapped up on top of the meat. Like I said, it's a little bit tedious. It can be a little bit messy, but the end result, I promise you, is worth it. Let's see here.
Shape there?
Well, anyways, the end product is going to look something like this. This one, I made it a little bit messier than I wanted to, but you get the idea, you get the gist. Try to, you know, get as much of it filled up as you can. I think I put a little bit too much stuffing in it, but anyways, you put it like that. Stick it on the baking pan, and you continue to make the rest of them. It works with your hands too, if you can tell. I kind of use the palm of my hand here. You don't really need to use a roller. Sometimes you can. It's really up to you. I'm gonna try this again with just a little bit less stuffing. Okay, that one definitely worked out better, but it's not as full. It will be all right. It just won't have as much stuffing in it. But like I said, you get the gist of it. You can play around with it and do whatever you got to do to please yourself. But there you go. Nice, beautiful looking. Again, put it on the baking pan. What I do is I make them all, put them on the baking pan. I turn the oven to 420, and I bake them for about, I put it at 10 to 12 minutes, but usually, depending on what type of biscuits you use, it ends up being about 15 minutes. So I'm going to go ahead and finish these up, and we will show you the end results. All right, so this is how they look before I put them in the oven.
This is first time Esme made them, and these are mine. But the cool thing about them, right, is you could stuff them with whatever you want. The first time I did it with ham and cheese, and then I did cheeseburger with pickle, and then I did forgot what I did last time. But I think this is maybe my fourth time making them. I really, really like them. Super easy. It took us, 15 minutes maybe to prep. That's including cooking up the meat, rolling everything out, getting them stuffed. You can cook them with whatever you want. The next time I make it, I really want to do almost like a meatball, you know, with some meat and some marinara sauce and cheese. And sounds delicious. We'll have to try that out. Anyway, so I have the temperature at 420 degrees. We'll go ahead and stick these bad boys in the oven. And we'll set our timer. I'm going to go ahead and do 12 minutes for now. And I'll see you in 12 minutes. All right, so timer just went off. Let's check these out. Oh yeah, nice golden brown. That's how we like them. Look at those. Tell me those do not look delicious. So see how you fold them over. If you put the fold on the bottom, it pretty much seals itself up. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed watching how we are making our dinner tonight. This is what we're eating for dinner, and I hope you guys try it. And if you guys try it, let me know. You guys can either put it in the comments or, you know, put pictures in the comments or send them to me or however you guys want to do them. Let me know how you guys do them. And awesome, easy dinner. All right, guys, so we're going to call it a day. We're supposed to have some pretty bad weather tonight, so I want to go ahead and try to get this video edited and posted. We are glad that you guys were able to come along with us today, and hope you guys enjoyed. So until next time, stay true to yourself, love one another, we love you, we miss you, and we'll see you on the flip side.